So it's wonderful to be here. So just a little bit of background about the university. Griffith University is a public research university. It's located in southeast Queensland, which is on the east coast of Australia. Formally founded in 1971, Griffith opens its doors in 1975. So we're almost 50 years old. And when it first started, it introduced Australia's first degrees in environmental science and Asian studies. A little known fact is about Griffith is that it has received more Australian awards for university teaching than any other university in the last 10 years, including the top teaching award, which is the Australian University Teacher of the Year Award. And this picture is of Dr. Kevin Larkin, who's from the School of Education and Professional Studies. He was the 2018 Australian University Teacher of the Year. He has over 35 years of teaching experience and has spent the past 7 years inspiring and motivating pre-service teachers and transforming how mathematics education is taught. Griffith is a comprehensive university. It teaches across a very broad range of areas of study in groupings where students can interact with students from other disciplines. We're offering within the sciences, architecture, construction, planning, science and environment, engineering, IT and aviation. Within business, there's business and government and tourism. Within arts, there is also education and law. And then in our very large health sciences precinct, one of the widest ranges of health science programs available in Australia. Griffith is ranked in the top 300 for most major global university rankings. As a young university, we have the freedom to respect tradition without being restricted by it. This allows us the flexibility to adapt to an ever-changing needs of students, industry, and the community. We introduced Australia's first degrees in a wide range of important areas from Asian studies and environmental science, which I mentioned earlier, to dental technology and forensic science. More recently, we're very proud of the ranking at the bottom of the slide there. And this is the Times Higher Education Impact Rankings. And this compares universities on research, stewardship, outreach, and teaching across the 17 UN Sustainable Development Goals. And this is very important for us. So we are now designing degrees with these SDGs in mind so that students are graduating with this very important protocol as we go forward. In terms of rankings, and if rankings are important to you, I would encourage you to dig a little bit deeper and look at subject rankings. For Griffith University, the top four areas of study are all in the top 50 of the world. And this is comparing ourselves with all universities globally, not just young universities. So our current rankings for nursing and midwifery is number two in the world with the Shanghai Jiao Tong ranking system and number one in Australia. Hospitality and tourism management has been regularly ranked in the top five. It's currently number three in the world, number one in Australia. Marine and ocean engineering, just in the top 20. And sports-related subjects at the university ranked in, coming in with the QS ranking system at number 31 in the world. But there are a wide range of subjects across all of our groupings that are ranked more highly than the overall ranking of the university. So I encourage you to dig deeply into the subject rankings if rankings are important for you as when choosing a university. Some of the more popular programs at the university, and the Griffith does offer over 200 degrees, but in the postgraduate area, these are the sort of most popular areas of study and that seem to be matching the goals of many scholarship programs. In the arts education law realm, we've got a Master of Education, Design, International Law Studies. There's the three-year or six-trimester Juris Doctor, screen production, and of course, research. Research is available across all areas of the university, and I'll mention a little bit more about research in a few minutes. In the business school, the key or most popular programs would be the two-year Master of Business, which offers over 20 majors for students. Finance-related degrees, either the Master of Finance, Financial Planning, Financial Technology, the very important Global Development, which is also written with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals in mind, the International Tourism and Hospitality Management is very popular, accounting, and then moving into health, social work, global public health, health services management, and pharmacy would be the most popular programs there. And in the STEM, looking at cybersecurity, information technology, the double degree with information systems and IT management, another double degree combining project management with civil engineering. There's also a master degree in aviation management delivered out of the sciences on the Nathan campus, as well as a master of architecture. In terms of research, Griffith has over 30 research institutes and facilities. There are 2,500 plus research experts, and we list these on our website in a search engine. We have almost 2,000 research students who are mostly PhD students, and over 5,000 national partners and over 200 international research agreements for students to take advantage of. This is an image of Sora, who came to Australia as a refugee and is doing an amazing job looking at cancer research. In terms of the areas of study, the university has identified several key strategic areas of importance that is driving our engagement and resources into these research areas, and I've listed them here. In this image is Associate Professor Halim Rain, who is a leading academic in Islamic studies and specializes in Islam-West relations. In 2015, he was named the Australian University Teacher of the Year by the Australian Department of Education and Training. Griffith has six campuses. There are five physical campuses and the digital campus. And as I mentioned earlier, it's located on the East Coast, just above the border with New South Wales. And it's considered a beautiful subtropical climate. So it's quite mild all year round. Not too hot in the summer, not too cold in the winter. The image here is of our Gold Coast campus, which is our most popular campus, not only for domestic students, but also for international students. In the background, you can see the beautiful skyline of Surfers Paradise. And in the foreground, on the right-hand side there, you've got the campus itself with the athletics field. The large building in the middle there is at the health clinic, where students and practitioners are working with the public. And behind those buildings are where students are studying engineering and business, architecture. The Queensland College of Arts is there, and all our allied health sciences and research institutes are there as well. On the left-hand side at the front are an array of buildings that are all related to health and health research, as well as materials research. And this is part of the Gold Coast Knowledge Precinct. There is the relatively new Gold Coast University Hospital with 750 beds. And right beside that is the Gold Coast Private Hospital with a further 250 beds. And this amazing precinct, health precinct, is driving jobs and investment and is now one of the fastest growing health precincts in Australia. It's our largest campus and growing rapidly. There are over 18,000 students. In fact, it's getting closer to 21,000 students. Part of the reason for this growth is related to Gold Coast being named a regional centre of Australia, and students are choosing to study regional centres because it allows them the opportunity to stay in Australia an extra year for post-study work rights. This is an image of the Nathan campus where my office is located, and I'm very lucky to have a beautiful work environment, and for students, a beautiful study environment. This is the first campus, and although it looks like it's isolated in a forest, deep in the bush, it's actually just about 13 kilometers from downtown. So just outside of this picture, there are transportation hubs, shopping centers, homes, businesses, etc. That yellow box that was in the picture is one of our newest buildings, the $40 million engineering and technology and aviation building, which is actually a living laboratory. There are sensors that have been developed in the production of the building where students can, in real time, measure forces, weight, water usage, electricity usage, or energy at any time. So they're actually using this as a very large experiment, if you like. So we are housing around 13 to 14,000 students in total in the Nathan campus. The university offers programs in trimesters. Some universities in Australia will offer semesters. So you've got two teaching periods a year. Griffith offers three teaching periods a year. This allows students greater flexibility of entering into a degree and choosing when to study, and allows for a fast completion or the opportunity to take a break and get some work experience in the middle of the degree. The university has for several years now been offering these three core merit-based partial scholarships, and will continue to do so for the remainder of 2022 and for the whole of 2023. So any student starting in the next four intakes, that's November this year, March, July, and November next year, will be eligible for one of these eligible to apply for one of these three scholarships. The merit-based scholarship is 20% and is calculated automatically for students who have a GPA or a grade point average of 5.0 on a 7 scale. If you are not sure of what that grade is in your system, then don't worry, our admissions team will calculate that, and they will automatically offer this scholarship to you if you're eligible. You do not need to submit a separate scholarship application. The 25% scholarship is very similar, except it's for students who are deemed at a 5.5 GPA on a 7 scale. And again, the admissions team will recognize your GPA and offer this scholarship to you in your letter of offer for the program. The third scholarship is a little different. You will need to apply separately for this scholarship, and it's for very high achieving students. But it's also much fewer in number, so it's more competitive. While there's a minimum requirement of 5.5, typically you'd be looking at more like a 6 to a 7 GPA to be in the running for this scholarship. In addition to the application for the scholarship, you will need to submit a personal statement. And this outlines your ambitions and why you want to come to Griffith, and what are your goals and ambitions once you graduate. So this has been a very quick overview of the university, and I hope that it's provided enough or plenty of information for you to now at least take to the next step and contact me, or decide that this may not be your university of choice. I hope it is. It certainly is a popular choice for many students, and I hope it will be a popular choice for you as well.